Write the series in summation notation. 10 plus 20 plus 40 plus 80 plus 160 plus 320. This is not necessarily an easy series to pick out the pattern here. You could think, oh, we're adding 10 and then adding 30, or what are we multiplying here? We can see that everything ends with a zero here, so let's try this. Let's try 10 times 1, and then this one it would be 10 times 2, and this next term would be 10 times 4, and then 10 times 8, and then 10 times 16, and 10 times 32. Well, that looks pretty nice. Okay, we've got a pattern then, 1, 2, 4, 8. That pattern that is happening looks like the powers of 2. So 1 is 2 to the 0 power, so let's rewrite that. We have 10 times 2 to the 0 power plus 10 times 2 to the 1st plus 10 times 2 squared. This is the 4 here. 2 squared is 4. Just matching that up. Plus 10 times 2 to the 3rd plus 10 times 2 to the 4th. Just to keep us on track, that is 16 is 2 to the 4th. Plus 10 times 2 to the 5th. Okay, now we see a series developing here where we've got something counting, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's the exponent that's counting. So let's take a stab at the summation notation. So we're going to say the sum of, that's the sigma, the sum of 10 times 2 to the n, but we've got a 0 there. Typically we start when n equals 1, so we'll say n 2 to the n minus 1, so that when n is 1, we're starting at 2 to the 0 power. And we have, how many terms do we have here? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so we're going to go up to n equaling 6. And let's just check that out. I want to circle this because I feel pretty good about that, but let's check it out. If I plugged in 6 here, I would have, this is hypothetical, when n equals 6, I would have 10 times 2 to the 6 minus 1, or that's 10 times 2 to the 5th. And yeah, 2 to the 5th is what we're looking for our last term. So, and that looks pretty good then. That is going to be our series in summation notation.